cultural news. Today we're at the Grand Victorian Convention Center in Mississauga with Soul Exchange for the Ultimate Sneaker Show.
What's the most expensive pair you've seen go today?
The Doran Becker 6s for $1,200.
Wow.
Alvin.
I just seen a pair of Yeezy Boosts that just came out a couple months ago, and that usually goes out for around $1,500. So. But I'm pretty sure there's a lot more deals going on.
Yeah, there's a lot of deals going on in there today. So
we don't know it, but
we bring the sneaker community to life. And today everyone is in there wheeling and dealing, trying to get an exclusive pair for that price. You know?
And there's shoes for everybody, men, women, children. I've seen toddlers with little baby sneakers.
Yeah. We like do have display. Vendors who carry toddler sizes. Women's sizes as well, men's sizes, spanning from size 8 to 14, so pretty much a full size run.
Yeah, and you guys are also running this new project of yours called Kids for the Homeless. Can you tell us more about that?
Well, we're just in the process of designing it, Alvin and
myself. Basically a give back system to the community.
Yeah.
So aside from doing it for the sneaker community, we also want to give out to the to those in need.
So how does that work?
Well, we're planning to get sponsors involved and hopefully get a lot of free pairs. We'll also be looking to, you know, give back some stuff from the Soul Exchange team as well. So we'll be leading the project, but we'll be looking to get others involved to assist us. But our main goal is just to go out there, find people that are in need, and basically give back to them. You know, we want to show people that we want really nice stuff, so we want to make sure others get nice things too and feel, you know, just a boost in their morale for the day is always a good thing.
And this is all taking place at your next event, your next Soul Exchange event?
It's going to roll into the event. It's kind of like a project that's going to lead up to the event, but I'm sure you'll hear more and see things. Like, we'll probably try to bring out a couple of the guys,
bring them to the show, and
get some pictures and stuff with the rest of the visitors.
This place is just mind-blowing.
It's awesome.
It's not bad at all.
We're gearing up for the summer show downtown. Alvin, Mathis, and myself, we're super excited. Venue to be announced, date to be announced, but definitely we're invading downtown Toronto with Canada's Ultimate Sneaker Show. You can find information about that at Soul Exchange Canada on Instagram, at Soul Exchange TO on Twitter, Soul Exchange on Facebook, and always you can check out the ultimatesneakershow.com and stay in tune with what we're doing. We're super excited, so we know the community is going to be ready for
this. So basically when people want to check out videos or pictures from our past events, the ultimatesneakershow.com is where they should go.
And Julia, you make the most amazing hats. You've got bow ties, suspenders. What's the process of making these?
Thank you, first of all. And yeah, I'm doing all of them myself, handmade. Basically, I have a homemade studio where I'm sewing them. So the process starts from hand picking fabrics, then sewing and like all the stuff, like social media and advertising. I'm doing currently all that myself.
So you actually sew these. So these hats that we're wearing, I saw this hat when I walked in here today and I said, I have to have that hat. I'm here with Mark from The Box, and this might be one of the coolest things I've ever seen. This is basically a box for your shoes. How does this work?
So basically how it is, let me just show you guys real quick.
Uplifted Society, a really cool vendor that we came across today, because you not only sell shoes, but you have clothing, and a lot of your clothing has meaning behind it as well.
Deep meaning. It started from just being involved with depression. Everyone on our team, we've dealt with a dark spot that we did not like. We figured, you know, no one's going to create our happiness, we have to create it on our own. So talking to all my friends, and I realized that they all had a dark space. So I used to pick small little ideas from them. So I was talking to my friend. I'm gonna show you an example of one of the shirts that I, my favorite one actually was the top selling one.
I love this one.
Yeah, this is my favorite actually. It's called Priorities, Prioritize. So I'm talking to my friend. He's pretty much telling me that he's going down the wrong path. There's drugs involved. There's just crime involved, and that's not my life anymore because I've changed and I came out of that darkness and I found the light. So just as I'm talking to him, he's telling me all these discouraging things, and I decided that the words priorities meant most to me. So it's like this.
And if you see,
prioritize. Now what that means is, in order for you to prioritize what's important, you actually need to get rid of negative prior ties.
And we're here with Zach Wine of ZB Customs. Hi Zach, thank you so much for joining us. Zach specializes in hand embellished shoes. So these are all hand painted, right?
Yes.
Can you tell us more about your process?
They're all hand painted shoes. I do custom artwork one of one for shoes. I have people send me their shoes, whether it be Jordans, whatever, usually leather. And I take them and I strip them down of their factory finish and their factory paint, and by hand I repaint the shoes and put a factory finish back on them so that they're completely wearable pieces of art.
That's amazing. So how long does it usually take you to do a pair?
Something like this usually takes me about 40 hours. These are all to scale hand-painted maps of Toronto.
So there's an actual pattern going on in here.
Exactly, yeah. All of these, I went on Google Maps and pulled it up on the computer and then sat there and looked at the computer while painting away. And ended up doing all the maps, 8 different communities in Toronto here for the show. And I also did the Six God sign that Drake came up with for the back of the shoes.
So which communities do you have in there?
Funny enough, these are different communities that I've worked in Toronto. I used to live in Toronto and I was a youth worker. I worked at the Lawrence Heights community, and they were the kids that really got me involved in sneakers. They were the ones who just taught me all about it. They were the ones where I started doing restorations for. So I put the Lawrence Heights community on this shoe.
Which one?
This
which
is
one
Lawrence is Heights.
Okay.
This is Rexdale community that I've also worked in. We have Jane and Finch up top and down bottom. And we have Regent Park, we have Galloway, Parkdale, and Scarborough Village.
That's awesome. So now we sort of like have a blend of, you know, form and function with your art.
Exactly.
In case anyone ever gets lost.
Take off the shoe and find your way around for sure, yeah.
I'm here with JR, Ben, and Michael. We're at Soul Exchange, and not only are people going around buying shoes, but you guys are trying to sell shoes today. So what do you have here?
So we got the Vince Carter Olympics and the KD Elites.
Can we see one of these? Can you open them up and show us? So yeah, they are actually trying to sell shoes here today. So you can actually not only buy shoes, but you can trade your shoes in condition. Those are nice. So how much are you planning on selling these for? Hopefully. So
for the Vince Carter's, trying to get me like $240. For the KD's, $180.
That'd be some nice cash in your wallet today.
Hi everyone, we have Doreen Jackson here, and she's been serving up amazing Jamaican food to the crowd here, and wow.
So wow.
Yeah, the lineup was so long. Thank you so much for joining us now that you finally got a break.
Most welcome, darling.
What are some samples of traditional, authentic Jamaican food?
Traditional Jamaican food, you have rice and peas with stewed chicken. You have rice and peas with brown stew, snapper fish.
Oh.
Yes. You have rice and peas with curry goat. And our traditional main food, like we have in a Sunday dinner, we have brown stew chicken with rice and peas.
Stewed chicken.
Yes.
Oh, nice. So when people think Jamaican food, that's the first thing that comes to
mind. That's the first thing, yeah. And then our main, now we have jerk pork. Mm-hmm. We also have jerk chicken, which everybody wants.
Just like what happened today, I was trying to get in line, but I didn't even see the table because her booth was packed.
Packed.
And everything's gone now.
Gone. All gone.
I'm here with Asha today. You are the manager of the Toonie Cancer Bracelet Campaign from the Canadian Cancer Society. And you have some beautiful bracelets here today. I actually ended up buying one myself. So how this works is...
How this works is you give a toonie and you get a bracelet. And from each bracelet, 50 cents goes to the Canadian Cancer Society to fund life-saving cancer research. So it's a magnetic bracelet, it's braided, and it's easy wear, like for seniors and kids and whoever, just look at that, easy wear. And
done. That was so easy. I have bracelets and they take forever to put on. That was very simple.
And also you can use it as a necklace, too. It's a necklace, there you go.
Beautiful.
Yep.
And each color has their own meaning as well. There's actually a chart here. And what's interesting is I felt drawn to going to the black bracelet. It's the first one that I chose. And then I looked at this chart, and sadly, there's quite a few people in my family who have battled multiple melanoma. And that is actually the cancer for the black bracelet. So that kind of hit home for me. So anyway, thank you so much, Asha, and good luck selling all of these bracelets. I know there's been lots of people coming here today and getting some bling bling. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
And there you have it. Thank you so much for joining us, guys. You can check out Soul Exchange again because they're coming back this summer. Check out pmntv.ca. Check on the links below. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. This is Michelle Charmaine reporting for Cloud Patrol for Philippine News Canada. Thank you for watching.